Hey folks, welcome back to the second module of the Adobe Illustrator Basics program. Today we're going to look at text on a stroke, which is essentially writing text along a curved path, the pen tool, the pencil tool, the align function, and how to add a picture or a background image. So to get started, we'll open a new file. Again, centimeters. Let's do landscape orientation. Again, I'm going to name the file class test. So we're familiar with this space. You should be starting to know the toolbar here. The big letter T is the type tool. Click on that. We can have some text. Pretty straightforward. Once that text is created, you can click on it and move it as you see fit. Also, notice that when the text is selected, we have these options here. So the font style, or the font style, whether it's regular, bold, italicized, and the font size. So let's change our font style. I'm a fan of copper black. Looks like our only option here is regular. And using the up arrow, I could change the size of that text. A useful shortcut, as you could imagine, I really like shortcuts. Control, Shift, and the greater than symbol. As I tap the greater than symbol, or hold it down, as you can see, the text grows in size. The opposite is true with the less than symbol. Text will shrink. So that's fairly useful. It can get you really far using the text. Before we talk about text on a stroke, we need to create some interesting strokes. I want to have you use the pen tool. Here you can see, open the menu, open the pen tool, and it's the shape of a old-timey fountain pen. Now, with the pen tool, once you click, you've created a point. And as you move your mouse around, the line will follow you, but it won't draw a straight line unless you really want it to. If I then do a single click, it will draw a straight line, but then it will continue from there. I could actually click quite a few times. And notice, when I return to my original point, as I hold this cursor over, a new symbol will appear. You see that closed circle that appears down below. That means that it will then be a finished or a closed polygon. So I could go ahead and click, and now I have my shape of whatever shape I choose to draw. And again, that was done by tapping the click button and drawing whatever I needed to. And again, once you return, you'll see the circle appear on my cursor. There it appears. And just like we had done last week, I could then select one of these shapes, have it be any color I choose. Currently, there's no stroke selected, but I could choose a stroke and a width, just like you had done last week. So now you have some goofy shapes. I'm going to delete these. Now, the pen tool takes some practice to use. If you click the pen tool like we had done, and on your second click you hold the click down and drag the mouse, you can draw a curve, a fairly accurate curve. So you can see here's my curve mark. The blue end indicates the center of the curve. And so I can make my curve do lots of different things. This really takes a little bit of getting used to. There are many tutorials on YouTube available to help you learn the pen tool. Also, this is a tool shared by almost every graphic drawing program that you'll find. One thing that I find is useful is it will oftentimes force you to draw a curve. Again, notice as I drag the cursor back over my previous point, a little V, inverted V, will show up. That means I can make a very sharp point in that sense. Again, it takes a little bit of time to figure out how to use the curve tool properly, but it's worth the time. So here I kind of finish my shape, and I have this weird looking shape here. So that's well and good, and using the pen tool is, as I mentioned, very powerful. I'm going to use the pen tool and draw a simple swoopy curve here. Let's see, I'll do something like this. And I'll select my arrow. There's many times where I may not want this to have a fill. I'm going to select transparent for fill, but I am going to select a stroke so we can see our shape. So we have this curvy shape here. There may be some instances where we would like our text to be arranged along that shape, and that's the type on, or the text on stroke tool. If I select text, notice that it shows a regular text box as I'm moving it around the document. But when I get close to my stroke, this line that I've created, a new symbol appears. This is the text on stroke tool. So if I select this location, my stroke will actually go away, but any text I type will be oriented along that stroke. So I'll go ahead and click. As you can see, as I type, my text is now located along that stroke. It can be a pretty powerful tool, lots and lots and lots of uses. So let's go ahead and get rid of that bit of text. And let's bring up the pencil tool. The pencil tool is different than the pen tool. If you close a shape with the pencil tool, it won't close automatically. And the pencil tool also does not draw curves. Pencil tool is similar to anything you may have used in Microsoft Paint at any time in the past 20 years, although it has some slight improvements. So you can see as I press click and hold my click and drag the mouse, it draws a shape. And we all know that it's incredibly hard to draw accurately with the mouse. As you can see, my shape doesn't look so great. I'm going to continue drawing, but I want you to watch what happens when I let go of my drawing. So I'm going to go ahead and let go of my click here. And actually, Adobe Illustrator will clean up my shape for me. So it's not quite as weird and angular as it was when I drew it. It's still not the best, but it's an improvement. So there's an algorithm built into Adobe Illustrator that will smooth your pencil drawings, which will improve your drawings if you need to. I use both the pen and the pencil oftentimes when creating geologic maps. Another tool you may find useful here is the default here you can see is the eraser tool. It will erase things, but I wanted actually to highlight, if you hold down your click, select the scissors tool, you can actually chop any shape up. So let's select a few points along the way here, along our pencil drawing that we've just done. We've actually now chopped that pencil drawing up into lots of different segments that can each be treated independently. Again, if used correctly, the scissors tool is one of my favorites, actually. Especially if you want one portion of a line to be a dashed line and one portion to be solid. I can give you an example. I can click here. This is a shortcut to bring up my stroke options. Dashed line. 6-point dashed line. And now when I look at my shape, I have one portion shown as a dashed line, whereas the other is shown as a solid line. Again, incredibly useful in creating a geologic map, which will be the ultimate goal. Okay, let's get rid of all of these scribbles here. And the next tool I want to show you is the align function. I'm going to add just a bunch of random text in random locations. We'll get everything nice and spread out. So we have all of this different text. Now it turns out, with Adobe Illustrator, we can do some pretty interesting things. So I'm actually going to select all of this text at once by clicking and drawing a rectangle with my selection arrow that encompasses all of this text. So it looks like I've grabbed everything. Now that all of these are selected, I'm going to bring up the Align window. Again, window, we saw last time that there's lots of sub-windows we can bring up. Here we see the Align window. This is, a favorite of mine. And it gives our options. So here you can see we can align everything left, horizontal align left. So just as the shapes were oriented in lots of different places, we can align them left. The same is true here. We can actually align them right. We can also align them in the center line. You can see here. So lots of options there. To the top. Horizontally, on the bottom, lots of different ways to do that. So let's go ahead and align center, horizontal align center. But the next thing that's bothering me is that they're not spaced evenly, especially here. These ones are stacked on top of each other. This is a case where we would use the distribute objects function. So vertically distribute center, if I click that, it will actually add even spaces between all of those different bits of text, and they'll look really great. They'll look really professional. Bam. Here we go. Now all of our text is aligned in the center and spaced evenly. We could approach this lots of different ways. I would suggest dinking around with the align features. You'll find that they're fairly useful. The last thing I want to do is actually show you how to add a picture. I'm going to open any file. You can open lots of different files with Adobe Illustrator. Usually I work in PDF. Let's actually add the base map that we had done before. So we'll open the Grave Point 1 to 10,000 base map. That's going to open in its own window. There's a lot going on in this image. Just to simplify, I'm going to select the image. Notice that you can see the image is selected, and as I drag it, the image itself is different than the canvas, which is shown back here. The way that I typically do this is Control-C to copy. Now let's go back to our class test document and press Control-V, which is the shortcut for paste. Control-C is the shortcut for copy. So now I have it pasted here, and it covers everything. Because we've learned about stacking relationships and how that works. So now I can right-click on this feature once it's selected, right-click, arrange, send to back, and voila, there we go. We've now worked through text, text on a stroke, bits of using the pen tool, how to use the pen tool, how to align objects, and also how to add a picture. You can add a JPEG, you can add a PDF, you can add almost anything you want. So that's the rundown for this section. Go ahead and you've seen how to save using PDF and use this these lessons to create this week's assignment. Great. All right. Talk to you later. Bye.